Today on our show, man,
Harley Quinn,
Luke Cage,
Green Hornet
that
reboot,
and so much fucking more. All over your face, neck, and chest, thanks to the good folks at Fat Man on Batman.
Yes.
Kevin Smith.
I'm Mark Bernardin.
Hey, and before we say a fucking single word about pop culture, we're gonna sell some shit.
Let's talk about your junk for a while.
Good shit. Yeah, where do you put your junk?
I put mine in MeUndies.
I put mine in my hand, but when it's not there, where does it go?
MeUndies.
MeUndies.com, ladies and gentlemen. Good folks at MeUndies have chosen, for some reason, to throw their money into the toilet of Fat Man on Batman. So here we are talking about it. And they sent us free underwear to try out, and they're fucking dope.
I'm kind of a fan. My wife is a fan.
I got a purple pair. It was black pair, but when you turn the inseam, the waistband was purple on the inside. They look like Batgirl underwear. I felt sexy in my Batgirl underwear. It's like underoos for adults. Mm-hmm. Every month they send you a box of fucking grunders, man. Men's. Women's, they don't give a fuck.
No, maybe children's.
Both sexes,
if
country
children
and
are
Western. Yeah, they might have fucking kids' undies as well. MeUndies.com, man, is the place to go. They'll send you a box of fucking grunders at the top of every month, and you wear the shit out of them. Could you imagine never having to go to a fucking store to buy your underwear again?
No, you know what? If you go to MeUndies.com/Fatman, enter the code Fatman, 20% off your first order.
And that first order is going to come to you and you'll be like, oh, you're going to rub the underwear all over your face because it's so fucking super soft. What's it made of?
Modal.
Which is 3 times softer than cotton, man. So you're going to do something you never thought you'd do. Take men's underwear and put it all over your face. Unless you're the guy who's like, I do that every day, dude. It's Tuesday. I do that on Tuesdays.
You know how I have it rigged in my house? I have the flash dance thing over my head. So I just put all my undies up in there and then I pull the thing and just poof.
And then he just bangs his head and
pretty
shit,
much
crawls across the floor to sell you MeUndies.
And I got that dude in the synthesizer in the corner just playing shit while I just
rock
out.
Maniac
for MeUndies.
And he loves men's drawers. And he's dancing like he's never danced before.
Well done.
Thank you. MeUndies.com, man. Here's the best part of this fucking MeUndies shit. Yeah. If you don't like it, let's say you put them on and you're like, you know what? I don't want to do this.
Yeah, these are too good. I can't handle this much.
Fuck this.
My junk ain't worth it.
Yeah, I devalue my junk. And so I want to stick it in lesser underwear, man. Fruits and Looms or whatever.
Yeah,
shit like
sandpaper baskets. I don't know.
I'd rather put a paper bag over my dick because that's free. Well, guess what else is free? Your whole first month of fucking MeUndies. Well, not free. I mean, I guess you pay for it the first time. 20% off based on our
They will refund your money and you get to keep the undies.
Are you shitting me?
I am not shitting you, dude. At all.
So they'll give you your money back and you get to keep the underwear?
Uh-huh.
How are these fuckers making money? Yo, MeUndies. Call me Kevin. Tell you to run your business fucking better than that. Well, there you go. That's good for fucking the consumer at home, man. You can try this shit on, and if you don't like it, you get refunded and you keep the fucking underpants.
Totally. Give them to people you'd like. Give them to people you don't like.
You
can
just
do
fucking
whatever
wear them and then tell for the rest of your life. Tell the story of I beat MeUndies.com. I'm wearing this shit free. They only last probably about 2 years or something.
Yes.
Then you'd have to do the scam again. But by then you might be like, I'm done with the scamming. I'm on the side of the right. MeUndies has shown me the way.
These last 2 years were horrible. It was like, it's a wonderful life, and that was the pivot point.
I was living in cursed underwear.
I was in the flashpoint of shitty underwear.
It's like I said thinner to the underwear. Or the underwear said thinner to me. That's how that movie goes.
Oh, deep cut.
I know, right?
Deep Stephen King cut.
King of Kings. So there it is, folks. MeUndies.com. If you haven't tried it yet, the fuck is your problem?
Don't cost nothing, man.
Unless you like them. Then it's cheap. What is it?
Yeah.
It's fucking the price of 2 cocktails.
Yeah. So what is
that? Come on, Lushy. Put the booze down and buy some underpants. That's what my fucking grandma always used to tell me when I was in grade school.
Put the booze down, Kevin. Buy some
underpants.
Clad your ass with something
walking
good.
Walking around the bottle, jug with 3 X's on it, bottomless, like Porky Pig.
With a bindle stick on one arm.
MeUndies.com. That's, you don't want to look like that kid.
No.
You want to look fucking sharp. You look, underwear is the most sacred piece of garment anybody wears, right? It's the last line of defense before people see what you got going on down there. So unless you got fucking, like, you know, you got something to impress, I don't, I got micro dick or whatever they call it, you better wrap it up at least in a nice package. Pair of fucking underwear that got donuts on them or ghosts.
If there's one thing that I've learned from watching a lot of cooking shows,
yeah,
presentation is very important.
That's true, man. This, show them you care.
This is like, you know, Bobby Flay made something awesome for your pants and it's inside them.
Wear dinosaurs on your dick to say that you care.
Do it.
And it ain't just dinosaurs. Every fucking month they send you some new designs, man. You get like enough underwear where you're like, holy fuck, you'd be drowning in this shit. Mm. Go to, what, this is a fucking deal. If you don't like it, you can tell them in so many words, shove it up your ass. And they're not even going to hold it against you. Like, give him his money back, and he can keep the underwear. Or she can keep the underwear.
Right.
Don't have to be a guy to be shitty on the phone to an operator.
No, it's equal opportunity shittiness.
All the way across the board. MeUndies.com/fatman, and you'll get a fat 20. Count them. I got you for 20% discount off your first order at MeUndies.com. All right.
Yes.
On to the news.
More news!
Let's see. When last we left our heroes, we were talking about, other shit.
Some other shit.
Well, we promised them we'd talk about the Harley Quinn movie. Let's start there.
Yes.
We all know there's a Harley Quinn movie coming after Suicide Squad. Why would there not be?
I mean, she was the character that popped out of all that.
Like, big time.
The narrative was about Margot Robbie and Harley Quinn.
And Joker to a very small degree. But they announced before the movie came out, they're like, we're making a Harley Quinn movie and stuff. So they were already bullish on the idea. And why wouldn't you? This character is just like printing money for him. They hired a writer to write the screenplay.
Christina Hodson,
that's,
I believe her name is.
The lady's name.
Yes, she wrote Shut-In, this Naomi Watts movie that just opened last weekend, I believe.
Okay.
She was also in part of the Transformers camp, like Paramount had put together this baby writer's room. Like Kirkman was in, and Michael Bay
Robert
was overseeing.
Kirkman?
Robert Kirkman.
Wait a second.
Mm.
They have writers on those Transformers movies? I mean, kids, you're hearing it here first.
Like, how about if this one just beats up that one
That's
for a while?
Literally, I thought the movie was
and
smashy,
then
smashy.
Turn into cars and
lasers,
things.
Funny piss jokes, and credits.
Yeah, but they did convene sort of this kind of high-level little room, and then they spent like a week or so, or 2 weeks, or whatever, banging out stories, and they would assign the stories out to other people. Like, Marvel did the same thing. That is how you got, Nicole, I can't remember her last name, who wrote Guardians of the Galaxy. She was part of like this writer's program.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that Marvel
before
put
James
together
Gunn came
before
in
getting James Gunn.
Wrote everything.
She was the one who flipped through the catalog and was like, oh, these guys could be fun.
Yeah, and you can, come on, man, a fucking tree man and a fucking talking raccoon.
How is this not a good idea?
Yeah, why didn't you guys make this already?
This should have been first. Iron Man's for losers.
They're like, hey, back off.
Simmer down, you can have it.
Fucking jeez, go write it.
So yes, my guess is she was a part of that writer's program, and then she wrote apparently a Bumblebee standalone movie that Paramount is really excited
Transformers
about.
Transformers Bumblebee?
Yes.
How excited I got. I was like, a movie about an actual Bumblebee?
B-movie too? She wrote B-movie too?
Sherry Seinfeld's back.
That guy needs the money. He hasn't been working
yeah,
for a while.
Like, I haven't seen him in a while. He must be broke by now. Okay, so the Bumblebee movie she
Yes,
wrote.
And then Transformers 6, apparently she's loosely attached to.
The one that's coming? The one that where they fight Nazis? Because I fucking suggested that on Smodcast. I want, hey, Bay! Credit where credit's due. Like an old episode of Smodcast, I was like, you know what they gotta do next, man? Transformers versus fucking Nazis. Hitler, go back in time, Panzer tanks turning into shit.
That would be badass.
You trust me. If this movie fucking goes forward, you will see me in court.
The People's Court.
Yeah. Judge Walker himself. He's going to pull his ass out of fucking mothballs and shit, preside over my case. I'm like, of course I have Wapner 3. Wapner 3.
Wapner 3.
Wapner 3. Talk about deep cuts.
So yeah, she is writing the Harley Quinn movie.
Good for her.
Which is apparently going to be a bit of a Birds of Prey kind of thing, where Harley Quinn is the chief antagonist and the Birds of Prey.
That's good. That's good. I can't even spit it out. I felt like that fucking dude on Gomer Pyle, the one who's a good dude. That ain't even Gomer Pyle. That's on Andy Griffith. I felt like that guy.
That
who's Gomer? Is Goober the one that's like, good?
These are deeper cuts than I can sustain.
True. You're like, I didn't watch those shows. Mayberry.
Saffron's son was
think
on.
You I fucking watched Mayberry?
Black and white and a bunch of white people in the middle of nowhere? I'm never watching that show.
Didn't realize we'd grow up to live in Mayberry, but there it is.
Chico and the Man was on for me. I don't know what you were watching.
How did we get there in the first place? Yeah, but
Goober,
what was I going to say?
Maybe, I don't know.
Oh, that's a good idea. I thought she would be the hero. But if what you're saying is she's the villain and the Birds of Prey have to go after her, like fucking Barbara Gordon in a wheelchair, Oracle.
Yeah, that'd be badass.
And who was the other one?
Black Canary and the Huntress.
Are you shitting me? Would we get a Huntress movie?
We could get a Huntress in a movie.
And like Canary movie?
And if it was me, like, I would make it to that. Yes.
Give him a single. Give him a single. He's pitching.
Harley Quinn is the bad guy, but we're in the perspective of the bad guy. Like, I want to see her trying to achieve her quest and the Birds of Prey trying to stop her.
Go back to a two-shot.
Why not?
Fucking that. That's why you pay a man like Mark Bernard to come up with good ideas that make money.
We're here for her. We're not here for the Birds of Prey. So she should be our hero, even if she's the bad guy.
Bang. But put Huntress in it, because I want to see that outfit. And she got the crossbow.
They did it on the first season of Arrow.
Huntress?
Yeah.
Oh, I was agreeing with something I didn't even know about.
Yeah,
I thought you were talking about they did Birds of Prey. I remember that. Remember they did the...
Yeah, they had Black Canary, and they had... They never did...
And they had a Harley Quinn, kind of.
They had a Harley Quinn. You never really got named as Harley Quinn, but you knew who it was.
Yeah. But they had a... Wasn't she the Doctor? Didn't they call her Harleen Quinzel or something?
No, there was a... They introduced a Suicide Squad.
No. I'm talking about the Birds of Prey fucking TV show.
Oh, that thing with like Dina Meyer 1,000 years ago?
Yes, bitch. Oh. Yeah, they did. They had Harley Quinn on that show. That was her first live action appearance, technically. Yeah. What's her name? Mia Sara played Dr. Harley Quinzel, and she would become Harley Quinn.
Oh, Mia Sara.
It's available on home video somewhere. I bet you it's on Netflix.
So many crushes on Mia Sara.
Right? Mia Sara from Legend, Mia Sara from Ferris Bueller's,
and then Birds of Prey.
And then Mia Sara. A few years between those.
Yeah.
That's right. All right, so good for fucking...
Christina Hodson.
Sounds like there's a Harley Quinn movie coming.
Maybe faster than the Flash movie, which...
My only piece of advice, make it awesome.
Please.
Coming from the man who made Yoga Hosers. So take that advice with a grain of salt. Michael Keaton.
Yes.
Batman from 1989. Tim Burton's Batman. My Batman in many ways, although Madam West is technically my Batman. But I loved the Tim Burton Batman.
We spent a long time talking about the Tim Burton Batman.
Michael Keaton. Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton, this is for you.
Michael Keaton was a choice to play Bruce Wayne Batman that... There was no internet, I've said this many times, back in 1988 when he was cast, the movie came out in 89. There was no internet back then, but people were so fucking outraged that they cast Mr. Mom as Batman that it broke the internet that didn't exist, and you heard it across the world, man. That's how serious that was. Now on the internet, you jump on your phone and be like, I don't like this shit. Anybody can whine, it's easy.
Yeah.
The newspapers whine, the magazines whine, and they had news reports. People going, have you heard that Mr. Mom is going to play Batman? People in the street are like, he ain't my Batman. Very reminiscent of current days and shit.
We're outside something called a comic book store, and do you read the comics, right, still?
1988 news report. It's very accurate. So, with that all being said, Michael Keaton, our Batman, who is not Batman anymore, unless they do a Batman Beyond movie and he's old Bruce Wayne.
Which would be so badass.
How metal would that be? But in lieu of that, I'll take what we now know to be true. They've been teasing, they've been fucking cock-teasing us for months with this. I think Michael Keaton might be in Spider-Man. And now it's true.
He is indeed.
And he is playing Uncle Ben. He's playing the Vulture, man. He's going to be like, love be a vulture tonight, I believe is the line from Mallrats. As a Stan Lee tells fucking Tia. That's cool as fuck. I can't wait to see this. I can't wait to see him as Ray Kroc in The Founder, which is out soon. That looks fucking amazing.
It's supposed to be for Oscar run, but they haven't set a release date, so it either needs to happen sooner or it's not going to happen until next year.
You're hearing that from the fucking film editor, son, at the LA fucking Times. That's right. You didn't realize. You thought we were just two fucking schmoes doing an internet show.
Which is true.
But he's got legitimacy. Legitimacy. All right, so there's that. Michael Keaton is a Vulture. We're all in support of that.
Absolutely. Why would there is nothing that I'm looking forward to next year quite as much as I am Spider-Man Homecoming.
Yeah.
Cannot wait for that.
Yeah, I'm all for it, too. Come on, that kid was amazing.
Tom Holland.
I watched just that sequence over and over again. I'll watch him and fucking Robert Downey Jr. not in suits talking to each other
just chilling.
For fucking an hour. Like, I don't care. I'll watch him not in suits, naked. Talking to each other for 2 hours.
In MeUndies?
They could even sit there. Yeah. They could be wearing MeUndies from MeUndies.com.
Or they thought you were done with the cell.
It's layered throughout. Or I would watch them sitting there naked in a chair like they were on fucking Westworld. That's the new thing, man. Like, I've been enjoying the fuck out of Westworld, but it's crazy. Like, when they signed up, They must have been like, you're going to be naked as fuck. You realize that,
and also in the most unflattering ways possible.
It ain't going to be Old West naked. You're going to be sitting in a fucking silver chair.
You don't get to like stand like an Adonis naked.
They hired pretty thin people. I've noticed that. Very shapely people who look thin while sitting down. Because they hired my fat ass to be in this show, and I sat on that chair. You wouldn't need, people would be like, what an amazing special effect. And it wouldn't be. Anyway, watch Westworld. That's my point.
It got renewed, season 2.
I know, but they're saying like the earliest, it might be 2018 or something like that.
Well, I mean.
Look, I'll take more whenever. HBO, how many more episodes they got? Time.
I think they did for 10.
Shit just fucking took a jump in the last episode.
I'm one behind, so don't spoil nothing for me.
Ooh, you're ready for a journey. Like, that's...
Yeah?
We're off to the races. Now we know what the show officially is about. And all it's fucking cool.
The thing that I've been... And the reason why you get the renewal now is that the viewership has been ticking up every week.
It's great.
Which
it's a great
almost
show.
Never happens. That is not the way television works.
Really?
Television works, you premiere big because the marketing spend is like... Everybody knows it's happening. Everybody tunes in for once. And then the audience begins to erode. Because some people just like don't like it. Some people fall away from it.
Not with this.
Not with this.
They've got an intriguing enough story where you're like, and it ain't even like The Maze. That ain't intriguing. Like, that's good, but that's not the fucking hook that keeps me dialed in.
And this was a big swing for HBO. Like, they had not. Because they had been on a losing streak for a bit. Like, Vinyl got canceled. Something else got canceled.
Excellent
like,
point.
Luck
yeah.
gets, like, they, like, Game
they
of Thrones.
They canceled that fucking talk show, too.
Yeah.
The one where Ben was like, oh, fuck, I love Boston. Boston!
Any Given Wednesday.
They canceled that.
Yeah.
So this show is a fucking bona fide hit.
And
they also renewed something else, too.
They renewed Divorce and Insecure.
And Divorce. There you go. Wow.
But yeah.
HBO on a roll.
But like Game of Thrones was all they had. And with Game of Thrones entering its final act, they needed a hit.
Now they got Westworld.
So
it's an awesome show, man. It's definitely fucking, like, I was in from the jump. You know, JJ, fucking, what's his name?
Jonathan Nolan.
I like the old movie and I like the concept, but like it's fucking Jurassic Park before Jurassic Park. They did this movie back in the 70s and based on a book and shit.
Same writer.
Same guy.
That dude loves parks.
And it's just stylishly made and smart as fuck, you know, talks about fucking evolution and thinking like, you know, perception, you know, self is, what am I talking about? Say something smart, Mark. Go to single.
I will say that I will watch Ed Harris and I will watch Anthony Hopkins and I will watch Jeffrey Wright talking amongst each other for hours on end.
Go back to a two-shot. Like, absolutely right.
Like, just the star power, the
but
wattage.
You know who's fucking
cast.
Like, who, in the beginning of the show, I was like, yeah, she's fine. But now, for me, is the fucking star is, what's her name? Plays Maeve.
He knows. JC's got to know. He's got computers and shit.
I almost forget
her name.
Yeah, she was in like that Jefferson movie years ago.
Oh, Tandy Newton.
Fuck, she's good, man. And fucking shit just lit up for her in the most recent episode that
aired. She's great.
But yeah, her arc has been like my favorite. Like her being kind of self-aware and shit like that. And so you saw the episode last week. Mm. Not last week, but the week before, where she's like, dial my shit up. Made her super smart. Oh, it's fucking good. She's running away with it. Everyone's wonderful in it, but she to me is just like, ooh, fuck.
Even
I can
like
see how this could keep going.
The lesser Hemsworth is good. There's a Hemsworth brother in that. Luke Hemsworth, the one nobody ever talks about. Plays like the beefy security guard.
Really?
Yeah.
That guy. He's good. He's good in the show. That's a Hemsworth. Jesus Christ.
The Hemsworth, we don't, like, they have them on trees, apparently.
Apparently.
In Melbourne.
And they can all act, and they all look good.
Yeah. Fuckers.
That motherfucker could sit in a chair naked and be all right. That's what I'm telling you. That's what I think about whenever I watch that show. It's like, it's fucking actors and actresses. I'd take my hat off to them. That's bold. That's brave.
And they would want
to
eat it because they can't eat anything because they have to maintain 2% body fat so they can sit naked in a chair and look good. I can't do that.
They do look naked and they do look good.
Yeah.
All right. That sounded creepy.
So that was Spider-Man.
We all look forward to Spider-Man. let's talk about the Hornet.
The Green Hornet?
Green Hornet is being remade already.
Yeah.
Not as a Seth Rogen comedy, no sequel to that or anything like that. They're giving it a reboot.
Yeah, Gavin O'Connor, the guy who did Warrior. Have you ever seen Warrior? Tom Hardy and Joel Edgerton, MMA sports movie. No. Nick Nolte plays their abusive father. It's great.
Oh, man.
It's really good.
Tom Hardy's in it?
Tom Hardy's in it. And he's
Nick
all,
Nolte's his dad? You're fisting your life away.
Pretty much. I know I was in drunk, but you can be something.
Get out there, Rock.
That's a different movie altogether, I guess.
But the same guy.
I'm going to watch that.
But yeah,
Warrior?
Warrior.
Fucking tip.
Yeah, it's really tight.
All right, so he directed that.
And
he directed
Accountant.
The Ben Affleck movie, The
yes.
Accountant.
Which every time I write, I put an I in there, so it's The Accountant. Which is, it's this
subversive as shit.
This weird fucking typo that I just can't get away from that tech. The Accountant. Taint? Taint. So yeah.
He's doing the Hornet.
He's doing the Hornet.
Feel the sting of the Green Hornet, motherfucker. Mm. And he's doing a serious take. This ain't goofy and fucking like, woo-hoo-hoo.
Right.
I mean, he wants to do a fucking serious as a heart attack.
I think he's enthused about the fact that it's a guy. He doesn't have powers. He's just got money. It's, you know, it's Batman, but if you're doing Batman,
you have to
for
do
real.
Batman. That's true. And he is saying that, you know, it's very serious, very dark. He's been chasing this for years, like something he's always kept an eye on because he loves the property. So he's going to get it, man. And he's writing it with a buddy of his, and we're going to get another Green Hornet movie. There
yeah,
you go.
Theoretically, anyway.
No, that's happening. That fucking,
that's happening.
That account movie was popular. And,
it made
and
money.
Also, like, Hornet is a really great property. It shouldn't just sit there.
Yeah.
You can build a whole universe out of it because you can spin off Kato movies and stuff.
You've had some experience in The Hornet.
I did. I wrote a script for The Hornet years ago. I was supposed to write and direct the Green Hornet movie. God, that's going back to the what? The aughts?
Mm.
And then I ran away from it because I was too scared. Mm. I was like, I can't do it. It's too big. My story I always tell about that is, like, I met the toy people. Mm. And they were like, here is the Black Beauty. Here is the ship. Here is the jet. And they hadn't even seen. There was no script. And so I was like, oh, like I had meetings with people, like I met with the Air Force for a fucking supersonic jet that they were like, you could use it. And it's called the Hornet and stuff like that. I had a lot of meetings that was just like, we don't even have a script. Why am I having these meetings? And that's when I was like, you know what? This is too big for me. Mm. But I did write it and stuff, but it never got made. But they turned it into a comic. You
Dynamite.
Can read Dynamite, published the comic, man, with art by Jonathan Lau. Jonathan
Excellent.
Lau was the artist. Phil Hester kind of adapted the script.
Ooh,
the guy
Hester.
That I worked
I love
with.
That dude.
I love Hester. But this was Hester as a writer. And he would do layouts, I think, for Lau, just to kind of break it down, because he was taking it from a feature script.
Right. That's a lot of work.
A comic script. It was a lot of work. He did a great job. Okay, so there you go. New Hornet.
New Hornet.
Bing, 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 bing.
You know what was?
Let's roll, Kato.
One of the most popular shows on the Netflix when it dropped?
Let me guess.
Hmm.
Stranger Things, of course.
Yeah, no, but Luke Cage.
Luke Cage?
You know how we know?
How?
Because apparently, according to a report that broke online, it was the highest, the biggest debut on Netflix this year.
And Netflix doesn't give out their data.
They
never tell you what their ratings are, but they used an agency that was just like based on hype and based on...
Pretty much.
I believe that. It opened strong.
It opened really strong. It broke the Netflix.
And they remember that one day?
Yeah, just that Saturday it dropped. It just shut down Netflix for a couple of
Number
hours.
Number one, it had a Marvel brand name going for it. Number two, it had something you never saw before.
Yeah.
It looked amazing. Number three, it delivered. Like, it wasn't like, oh, you get halfway in and this blows. It got better as it kept going and stuff. So I could see it, man. They can do no wrong. They can do no wrong. They're like Pixar. Marvel and Pixar right now can do no wrong.
Mm. I hate them all.
Even while in Cars 2. But that's not wrong. It's not
good.
Wrong.
It's
Some people like the Cars movie.
Good Dinosaur has its fans. 50%
of the population likes watching cars go very fast in a circle. So people, I bet you a lot of people like Cars. I was never that big into Cars. I did like the George Carlin bits, though. I liked the movie enough, but not to see Cars 2.
Yeah.
Did you ever see Cars 2?
I saw Cars 2.
And?
It's not that good.
You know, like, park it. Mark Bernardin says, Cars 2, park it.
When the trainee fell out of the Cars franchise, Cars 2. Even though, like, Michael Caine was playing, like, a British spy car.
Really?
That was pretty sweet. But, I mean, I will listen to Michael Caine do, like, Britishisms all day long.
That you were gonna say, I would listen to Michael Caine do my wife. Like, look, I like him too, but that'd be awkward.
My face, you monster.
Felt like you liked fucking Michael Caine more than me. I know I said it.
She's like, some men like to watch me fuck their wives.
He's like, my cock is the size of a tangerine. okay, moving
Luke
on.
Luke Cage. And then
Luke Cage, so that's awesome.
That's awesome. There's still no sign of a season
Yay,
two.
Yay, comics.
But
Yay, Luke Cage. Yay, Netflix.
Woo!
Our glorious leader.
All hail Netflix.
It's true, man. Like, what do you, who do you interface with more? A human being or your Netflix on your phone? I'm always watching.
Yeah, no, every lunch hour at the times, I just, what am I going to watch? I'm going to watch old episodes of 30 Rock.
You know what I watched the other night that I didn't even fucking know, because I think we were shooting when it dropped, was Mascots.
Oh, Ryan, the movie by Christopher Guest.
Chris Guest, man, it's fucking funny. That's on Netflix now. We sound like a commercial for Netflix. They ain't paying us. We're just big believers, and we have no lives.
But you could sponsor us if you wanted to, Netflix.
Yeah, fucking throw us a little money. I fucking pay you all the time. This is a one-way street, Netflix. Turned quick, didn't it? Mark Hamill, legendary Mark Hamill, most famous probably for his appearance in Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back.
I was going to go Corvette Summer, but that's just me.
Okay, and he also made a Star Wars movie or two. Yeah. Mark Hamill, the beloved Mark Hamill. Hey, kids, it's Mark Hamill. Has a new show on Comic-Con HQ called Pop Culture Quest. And Mark is a great talker. So I haven't seen the show, but I would say watch the fuck out of it.
I've never met Mark Hamill.
Really?
Really. I never have. I've met lots of people who met Mark Hamill.
I'm the nerd. Aren't you the editor of the film section at the LA Times?
I am indeed.
You have enough power to just be like, bring Hamill to me.
Deliver unto Hamill what is Hamill's, which is me.
No, you would have him brought to you.
I know.
That's true power. That's strength, boy. That's power. That's
the my strength James and Earl power Jones. Of flesh.
That's my James Earl Jones.
That's a good one. Look at him.
Come to me,
look
child.
Look at Hamill in the tree.
Come to me. He was convincing. I remember seeing that. And like, I was a Catholic student and shit, and going to school wearing a uniform. And when he fucking talked that person off the ledge, they just stepped off and jumped. And he turns around. He's like, that's strength, boy. That's power. I was sitting there going, he's got a point. I've never seen Jesus do anything like that. This Tulsa Doom, he's got my vote.
The strength and power of flesh. Look at the strength in your body.
I remember fucking Sven, who played LaFours and Mallrats. He was in it at one point, like the fucking stew of heads.
Yes.
Rolls out and they cut to him. He's like, the dog cocking the head.
It's like non.
Na na na. Was that movie?
That was that movie.
All right. I was like, am I doing the right song?
No, that's Excalibur, but let's just go with it.
That's what I was afraid of. I was like, but Excalibur is...
It's a Carmina Burana. Very similar.
Excalibur. Excalibur, where you see Mirren naked. Remember, she's Morgana Le Fay, and she sleeps with her brother.
The charm of making. Sex.
Yeah, the charm of making in that movie. She fucking makes her brother.
I tried the charm of making.
And now,
Nathra, Ulfas, Bethud, Dochiel, Dienve.
Holy shit. Why didn't we fucking bring Satan here? Oh my God, we were in unison on the charm of making. Somewhere a portal has been opened up.
I got a pentagram this
and
shit.
And true evil has entered in the world, just not here.
No.
Because we weren't pinpoint accurate, so it wound up in like Pacoima or something.
Was fucking devil outside.
Yeah, who released this? Us. While doing Fat Man on Batman.
Sorry.
Anyway, that's fucking dope. That's dope, man. Soulmates, you heard that shit.
Charm of making.
You know how many fucking people know the charm of making? Not a lot.
Like, it's you, me, Grant Morrison.
Do you think he knows it?
Oh, he knows all the magic things.
He must, right? Anybody who likes Excalibur. Who was it? Guy Ritchie apparently likes Excalibur. That's why he made that King Arthur movie. Did that come out yet?
Nope. Next year.
Coming?
March, I think.
Oh, really? I thought it was in the fall or some shit.
No, it feels like a March film.
The trailer looks hot, but I talked to the dude, Jax from Sons of Anarchy. Oh, he plays King Arthur.
Yeah, whose name
British
is escaping
dude.
Me. Hunnam. Charlie Hunnam.
Charlie Hunnam. And he was saying that Guy Ritchie and him love Excalibur.
I mean, it's
who
it's
doesn't
not a bad
love
movie.
Excalibur?
It's
an amazing
movie. Liam Neeson's in that movie.
The charm of making.
That's a pretty good Nicole
That's my
Williamson.
Nicole Williamson. Thank you very much. I bust that out on my wife from time to time. Like, who do you want me to be tonight? She's like, Nicole Williamson. I'm like, the charm of making.
Let your loss keep you afloat.
Is that that's all the news I got there? But hold on, I know there's
we got Luke Cage. We talked about Negasonic Teenage Warhead.
Tell that story.
There apparently has been a little horse trading behind the scenes between Marvel, Disney Marvel.
This is a great story. I've heard this before.
Yeah, and 20th Century Fox, which released the Deadpool movie. Apparently, the way it worked was James Gunn wanted Ego the Living Planet for Guardians 2.
Had written him into it.
Had written him into it. Said couldn't do it without it. Probably did not tell Fox this when he said, hey, you mind if we take Ego the Living Planet? Who apparently was written into Fantastic Four books, that's his providence.
So Ego belonged to the FF books, so that meant he belonged to Fox.
Because Fox owned the FF.
But James Gunn at Disney Marvel wanted to include Ego the Living Planet in Guardians of the Galaxy 2. But he would have had to have asked Fox, and right. Fox and Marvel Disney historically have been like, go fuck yourself! Go fuck yourself!
Right. So, to borrow a
pretty much
to borrow a line from Excalibur, he has given, now you must.
Ooh,
nice. So in exchange for Ego the Living Planet, Marvel, Disney, James Gunn, offered.
I think it was vice versa. I think Fox reached out to them
because they wanted Negasonic.
Yes, Fox reached out to Marvel because they had Teenage Negasonic Warhead, the character from Deadpool, and they wanted to change her powers in the movie a little bit. So they had to ask Marvel permission to do that. Apparently, like, even though like fucking Sony's got Spider-Man, if Sony's like, hey, in this new one, he shoots webs out his dick, they can't do that
right.
unless they ask Marvel. And I think Marvel at that point would be like, no. So they asked Marvel, they're like, hey, we want to change your powers. And Marvel Disney and, you know, X-Men Marvel, historically not on the same page.
Not entirely.
Came to a deal. They were like, you know what? Okay, but we'll take Ego the Living Planet.
Right. And which, like, I'm sure they did not
what?
Say.
And then for what? And they were like, I don't know, future use. Yeah, they never said.
Yeah,
for Guardians of the Galaxy.
It's like it's a bit of cameo or something. We just put them in the background. There needs to be a planet in this scene, so Ego would be cool for their fans.
And meanwhile, all along, they had fucking Kurt Russell in mind. James Gunn wanted to cast Kurt Russell. He at least wrote Ego into the fucking script. So that little bit of you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours, but Fox had no idea how much scratch they were giving away. Because if you've seen that fucking trailer at the, not the one that's online, but the one they had at Comic-Con,
yeah,
Ego's huge. Like, Kurt Russell is huge in the trailer and has some of the best fucking jokes.
But then again,
it's got a dick joke.
I mean, Negasonic did all right by them.
Yeah. Nobody lost in that.
No, everybody wins.
She was phenomenal. And they were right to change her powers, particularly because it fit into that movie. So there you go. Who knew? Yeah. My big question was, like, why did Marvel Disney have X-Men rights? Like, why did they have any say over Teenage Negasonic?
I mean,
probably Mark's theory, go for a single.
Is because Grant Morrison invented Negasonic Teenage Warhead in his new X-Men run, which might sort of be before Fox got their hold on the X-Men rights. So it's a new character, and so Marvel still has a little providence over it. That is purely conjecture and theory. It could just be that because it's a character that originated in the books and whatever, Marvel still has some say over from even a licensing perspective. Like, you get to correct, or you get to make sure that the character as you see it falls in line within reason for what the character was in the books.
There it is. Fucking well
maybe
explained.
Maybe.
You think this dude passed the bar?
I don't pass any bar. Glug, 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 glug.
In overview news, Cyborg Superman is coming to Supergirl.
Kick ass.
It's awesome.
Fantastic.
Pretty sweet. Also, I'm pulling this off of our favorite website, comicbook.com. Some people like there, don't fucking just read news off the internet, you fat piece of shit. Tune out anytime you want. I don't know what I can do for you. This is what I'm interested in talking about. This Justice League Dark cartoon. R-rated cartoon they're doing.
Well, I mean,
they're in the grown-up business now. Warner Brothers Animation.
They're not
man.
Fucking around.
No. Like, well, someone's fucking around in the comics. Like, ooh, Batman, Batgirl had sex in that fucking
doing
game
it,
joke.
Doing it well.
Now, I guess Justice League Dark's gonna get an R, and apparently it's gonna have some influence on the Justice League Dark movie.
Oh, that's cool.
The real movie. Yeah, I mean, you could tell they're threading the needle. Cause some people are gonna be like, Justice League Dark. You think they're going to call it that? Justice League Dark?
Probably not.
That'd be too confusing, wouldn't it?
Yeah, you would think so.
Beauty and the Beast.
And they're getting Matt Ryan, right? The dude who played Constantine on the TV show, to voice Constantine in Justice League Dark.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it's not
that's
bad.
That's very cool. Beauty and the Beast has a trailer.
It does.
For the live action movie directed by Bill Condon. Neighbor of mine. Yes.
Bill
yes.
Condon? Where does he live?
He lives up the hill.
Up the hill.
That's right. Bill Condon. He directed Dreamgirls. Mm-hmm. He directed some Twilights and shit. Now he's directing this Beauty and the Beast movie. And you've seen the trailer if you haven't. It looks like a cartoon. Yeah,
you're the only one who hasn't seen the trailer.
That's the point of this story, is that this trailer was the fastest, most fucking watched, biggest dick ever in the history of trailers with dicks or something like that. Everybody, all the internets watched this trailer faster than they watched 50 Shades of Grey and what is the other one? Star Wars.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the sweet spot for this audience is so fucking huge. Like, I remember when I saw Jurassic World and the money was making. And it's like, wow, that movie? Like, it's good. I like it. But really, that much money?
Nostalgia.
That audience, like, at 1993 when they saw that movie, those people are now 27 years old, 26 years old.
Yep.
I think that same split exists with Beauty and the Beast. What was that? Like, 91, 92 maybe?
So it was before I made Clerks.
Yeah. So it's, I mean, it's going to make all the money.
It's going to make all the monies that were ever printed, probably.
Jesus. Can't imagine. And it's still a musical. And it's got all the songs that you love. And
it's still a musical?
Yeah.
So they sing like,
so they sing, one fucks like Gaston, no one sucks like Gaston.
No one gets it up his old tucks like Gaston.
Yes.
Yeah, that's why we're not in charge of that movie.
No.
We have a new set of lyrics we'd like to do, Mr. Disney. Like, number one, Mr. Disney's long past. Yes. Number two, get the fuck out of our offices. This is Universal.
Suck my dick, suck my dick. Go ahead, take a lick. Try the white stuff, it's delicious. Don't believe me, ask the missus.
That's where this show's going. Right in the fucking sewer. Speaking of right in the sewer, here's a little gossip, man. It's not so much gossip, confirmed. Carrie Fisher alleges an affair, a three-month-long affair with Harrison Ford while they were making Star Wars.
Because of course they did.
Like, we all dreamed about that. I did. When I was a boy, I was like, I hope they fucked. I was only seven, and I would say that to my mother. She'd be like, did you have a good day in school, Tiger? I'd be like, I really hope Carrie Fisher and Harrison Ford fucked in real life, Mom. She'd be like, oh, Tiger. And I'd go to sleep. Who knew? That's hot.
It's super hot.
That's why there was real cats. That's why I love you. I know. Like, that's why that sizzle worked, dude. Because...
Although by that time they had stopped sleeping together, so that must have been a little weird.
Yeah, that's true. How weird was it fucking on The Force Awakens, man, years later?
And yeah. It's like, remember that time on Tatooine?
Yeah. Yeah.
You ever get sand in uncomfortable places?
Jesus, she's like, that's that other fucking Star Wars. Let's see, what else, man? Killer Frost coming to The Flash next week.
Whose fault is that?
I might have something to do with
it. Really?
Savitar was just introduced at the tail end of this most recent episode, season 3, episode 6. You get your first glimpse at Savitar. But in Killer Frost, the next episode, episode 7 of season 3, directed by Silent Boob himself. Silent Boobs. He you see a fuck ton of Savitar. No. Oh, yeah. You see a Savitar fight. You see some shit, man.
Kick ass.
Yeah, it's very, very cool.
Well done, my friend.
So, thank you. Well, I got lucky with the script. Boy, oh boy, tune in for that episode. They're putting pictures up all over online now of her, of Danielle, as Killer Frost. Mm-hmm. So,
she looks great.
There's a fight with fucking, I'm not going to say anything.
Ice fight? Do you have Let It Go? Did you play Let It Go in the background when they were saying, when they were at
I'll reveal something here.
Okay.
It's not that big of a spoiler. Mm-hmm. At one point, because the pictures are online, at one point you see the pictures online, Killer Frost is in like what looks like a frozen food warehouse. Mm. We have an exterior shot where you see a truck parked outside, and so like, what do you want to call the place? And we went through the DC universe looking for like a reference, but it gets very tricky. You can't like reference like characters that are in a line that has been licensed by somebody else. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So you can't just be like, hey, the Royal Flush Gang, because like that belongs to Justice League. You can't talk about that on this show. So, you know, you can't just pull any old fucking reference to drop in there. So I said, oh, let's call it like it was an Asian frozen food place. Mm-hmm. Had like, you know, Asian characters. And then it said, the name in English said Leaded, L-E-D-D-E-D, and then a separate word, G-O-H, let it go, frozen foods. That's our only frozen joke. Spoilers!
Disney will want their money now.
Yeah, they're going to get it too. So that's going on, man. Let's see what else is going on before we dive out of here.
Anything of interest, of import?
Always, but, you know, nobody wants to watch me scroll through the fucking internet. I just want to see if I missed anything new. Steve Carell is going to be in a Minecraft movie.
You heard it here first, kids.
Let's go out on a positive note, shall we? boy, that didn't go over as well as I hoped.
World ending. Minecraft movie.
Russo brothers are out scouting. Mm-hmm. They're on the scoot. They're scooting for a location. They're going to make that fucking Infinity War movie, son. Two-parter, man.
Happening.
Avengers. Man. I'm not much of a praying man anymore, but I pray to the Lord, my sweet Lord Jesus Christ, every night, please just let me live as long as the Infinity Wars movies. Both of them, not one. I don't want some backdoor trickery deal like the devil. He's like, I was never God. I was Satan, and I fucking tricked you to only get one movie. I want them both. Then I could die.
Here's the insidious thing, though. Marvel will never stop making these movies, so you're just going to have to live forever.
Then I trick God. Yeah. Then I am the master of God, master of puppets. I'm pulling your strings. He's like, that's about cocaine, you fat jerk.
Dormammu, I'm here to bargain. That's
fucking
it.
A. That's my moment with God.
Pretty much.
Dormammu, I'm here to bargain.
Dormammu.
I never got tired.
No.
I was never sitting there going like, I get it, move on.
Nope.
I just love that they have fucking Dormammu in it. And I'm not going to say it the way they said it. I know that's the correct pronunciation, but I've been saying Dormammu my whole life.
You know, live it.
Since I was a fucking child. I'm not changing.
I've been saying Han Solo since I was 5 years old.
Hand?
Han Solo.
As opposed to Han?
Yeah. Good. I'm just sticking with it.
Yeah. You know what? We're rebels. That's how we got where we got in life, by not joining the fucking establishment. So I'm going to say Dormammu, and he's going to say Han.
And Pluto's still a fucking planet.
Amen. Fucking some shit ain't changing, America. Me and Mark are here. Guarding the wall, standing on the wall, if you will.
And the galaxy. Guarding the galaxy and the wall.
And the wall. We're doing it all. That's all we got, right?
That's pretty much it, my friend.
Fucking A, man. That's all the news that's fit to print, folks. Thanks for hanging out with us here in the Fat Cave, man. Come back next week and we'll do something else. Something fucking same, but different.
A little different.
Different,
but same.
At the same time. I'm Kevin Smith.
Mark Bernardin.
Tune in next week for the next Fat Man on Batman. Say we're whenever. Not even. Maybe tomorrow.
Could be tomorrow.
Come back again one day.
There'll be more.
For Fat Man on Batman. Same fat time. Same fat channel. Smodcast.com or
YouTube.com/KevinSmith.